My friend, what is north plus north? It's zero, isn't it? If there's no God, no creator, how to get a universe from nothing? Over to you. Okay, so what went bang, my friend? Tell me, what was the energy source behind the Big Bang? You've no idea, that's it, because people are atheists. No idea why they're actually eating. They just don't want to believe in God. Now, here's a question for you. Those who are going by, you've got grandparents. I'm going to ask you a question about your grandparents now, okay? When your grandparents were teenagers, was there more or less suicide than there are today? When your grandparents were teenagers, was there more or less suicide than there are today? What do you think? Over to you. Well, there's a lot more today, isn't there? Do you know why I think that is? If you tell everyone that they're an animal, you don't matter, there's no purpose, there's no meaning, well, is there any wonder that people are going to end up killing themselves? This man here, number one, does anybody know who that is there? Someone shout out, who is it, lad? Harvey Weinstein. Do you know what Harvey Weinstein was known for in the news recently? Very recently, he was known for being a nasty, let me tell you this, you mark my words, we'll have many more Harvey Weinsteins coming out in the news soon. We'll definitely have more of them. Harvey Weinstein, as you know, was a nasty, horrible man. If you tell our children, if you tell everyone they're animals, is there any wonder people act like animals? Come on, we didn't come from a slime. Do you honestly believe that? We don't believe in God. If you don't believe in God, if you don't believe in God, you believe we came from slime. That's what scientists tell us, when we came from something called primordial slime. So we came from slime. Who God's a man? So where did we come from, sir? Jesus has seen him. If you'd like to stop and know, but what do you believe in, sir? Where did we come from? You can't get a universe from nothing, guys. It's impossible. There's no way you can get a universe from nothing. North plus north always equals north. Let me ask you this, okay? You name me, if you're an atheist going by, here's a question for you. You name me one explosion in the whole history of humankind that's caused anything good, any order, okay? You name me just one explosion that's caused anything useful in this world. Whenever I think of explosions, I think of Hiroshima, I think of Manchester, I think of September the 11th, Afghanistan. All those explosions have caused mess and chaos. And yet, the world will tell us we came from an explosion, the Big Bang. I'm sorry, friends, I'm not buying it. There's no way I'm buying it. Here's a question.
Well, apparently not.
Was there anyone going by in this wallet now? I want to tell you, in this wallet now, is something very, very precious, something amazing is inside this wallet. Is there anyone now in the streets of Wigan who would like to swap the contents of their wallet for what's in this wallet? If anyone wants to do it, it's absolutely yours. If anyone wants to swap the contents of their wallet for this wallet, it's yours. But I'll tell you, there's a bit of a catch. When we swap wallets, there's no going back. So is anyone willing to swap the content, before you know what's inside it, of their wallet for this wallet here? Anyone want to do it? No one wants to. I tell you, you're not as stupid as you guys, as I look, okay, sorry. As I look, that's right, so I don't want to be rude. This is what's in the wallet. Nothing. You see, friends, we've been told that if we get drunk at the weekend, we have sex outside of marriage, if we follow after all these things, success and things like that, we're going to be happy. But you look at the celebrity world, friends, you look at them and you see how many celebrities had the whole world at their fingertips and what they've done with their lives. They've killed themselves. This world cannot fill your heart. You know you're empty. You might enjoy it on Saturday night, but what do you feel like on Sunday when the hangover's there? Loneliness. We're all lonely. We're searching for something bigger. Do you know what we're searching for? We're searching for God. You might think I'm stupid. You might not like what I'm saying. But I'm just being real with you guys. And I'm doing it for a place of love. I hope you can see that. Anyway, I've got on this board, I've got the 6 most hated people ever to walk on planet Earth. So if anyone can name any of these 6 most hated people, please do. Please name them. So who's number one is? Does anyone know who number one is? Someone shout out. What do you think, sir? anybody know this guy here? Number two. Can anybody name it to me number two? It's a bit hard at that. Is there anyone know who that one is? He knows. Do you not know? Ted Bundy, okay? Number three. Does anybody know who number three is here? Can anyone name it? Michael, Matt, Tom, okay, number four, you all know that guy is, horrible, nasty looking man. Number five, does anyone know who those guys are? You don't use this, it's a war murder. Now, number six, we're going to do a bit of a social experiment now. Number six, I promise you that when I turn number six over, people do not like this person at all. He's more hated than Harvey Weinstein. He's more hated than Jimmy Savile. Number six, people do not like this person whatsoever. So everyone just take a look now. There's a couple of people stopping. Everyone look to your left. Everyone look to your right. Take a mental picture of everyone who's here now. Because I promise you that when I turn this over, at least one person is going to walk off because you do not like this person so much. But it was said about this person that they hated him without a reason. So if you walk off, just as you walk off, say, what is the reason why I'm walking off? Are you ready? We're going to reveal it now. Are you ready for it? Okay, he's thinking. You give me 2 minutes to tell you why this person is special. I promise you, you'll remember it for the rest of your life. Now, even though we might not like Jesus, even though we might hate Jesus,
Harry Potter's a better
book. Jesus really, really loves you. And that's why I'm standing here. I don't like you in this. I feel quite embarrassed. If my wife could see me now, she'd be laughing at me. But I'm telling you that Jesus loves you. You see these fists here now? Here's a question for you. Do you think these fists have ever hit anyone before? What do you think? Yeah, you think they have. I said it once and a guy shouted out, no, because you look soft. Well, I know I look soft, but they have hit people before. What about these feet here? Do you think these feet have walked to places they shouldn't? What do you think? They have. Okay, what about these eyes here? Do you think these eyes have looked to things they shouldn't have? Now ask me this question. Someone ask me this question. Are you going to heaven?
Oh, Christ.
I am. The truth is, I'm going to heaven. Not because I'm good, but because there's two types of people that get to heaven. Perfect people and forgiven people. Now, is there anyone here now who's perfect? You're perfect. Maybe you love fish, you're perfect. You try to be, but we can't worry, we're human. But forgiven people get to heaven. And when Jesus Christ hung on that cross, he took the punishment for all the wrong things you've done, all the wrong things I've done. It's a bit like this.
The way you move that.
Rolled up his sleeve, each human's heart, pulled out all the muck, all the crime, all the sin. He then laid it on Jesus and then crushed Jesus for 3 hours for you and me so we can be forgiven. One last challenge for you. This is a challenge now, okay? What would you think of me if I said to you, Harry Potter is a terrible book? What would you think if I said to you, Harry Potter is a terrible book? Okay? What if I said, Harry Potter is a terrible book, but I've never read it before? What would you think of me then? We'd say read it first and then make a judgment. Please, please don't say the Bible is a load of rubbish without reading it first. I'm going to give you a portion of the Bible for free. If anyone wants it, take it from my hand. It's yours absolutely for free. Read it through. Jesus loves you. He died for you. Thank you for your time.